New Delhi, our national capital, busy, sleepless, and full of hustle and bustle. Cars plying on the roads 24/7. This is our urban Delhi, the Delhi of dreams, of life, of liveliness, and of noise. But somewhere within the noisy and busy streets of the rich Delhiites are the silent and poor corridors of the Delhi slums. This is our documentary. Let the pulp show up. People define pulp as the soft center of something. Could be the soft center of human heart too. So it struck the hearts of me and my friends, and we ventured to explore the slum life, the slum area within the South Campus region. Filth, dirt and garbage are just a stone's throw away. Here, pigs roam in streets with humans. Two of my friends of our college, ARSD, visited the core areas of the slum, and all that happened to them was they were moved.
People living normal lives, even with sufficient privileges, can help these underprivileged people. We people, on behalf of our NGO, we go to the schools located in the areas where underprivileged people live. We teach these students any subject that in which we are proficient. The subjects range from general science and mathematics, social studies, to even French and Korean languages.
We discussed the scenario with another close friend, Nikita, a soul philosopher and economist. And there were debates as to why people can be so stone-hearted to pretend to ignore the condition of slum lives, how people could not have even 1% of their soft hearts affected. For the conditions and living standard at slums was far below what we could even imagine. Moved by this, our economist friend couldn't resist investigating the root of the problem.
The slums are the part of the Indian society today. They constitute the underprivileged section. The development of the country is not only governed by the currency value or the development of the stock markets, but by the development of the unused human resources, that is, the people who are unprivileged, as they don't have access to normal resources and especially education. Government has carried out mass education programs on wide scale. The most relevant example in this case being the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. The other possible measures could include generation of employment at the grassroots level, and secondary, the shifting of the human resources from the unorganized section of the sector of the society to the organized sector. Progress of such sections are not only the obligation of the government, but in general the public. The most effective measure in this context being the active mobilization of the youth in different programs for spreading education.
Discussions went on happening, and so did the quest for finding the answer of these questions. Like, where are the slums headed to? What is the future of these slum dwellers? Are they ever going to have a nice future? This man is a slum dweller and works as a daily wage laborer. He works as a painter and has 4 children to look after. His kids will obviously be more prone to diseases, seeing the unhygienic conditions at the slum. With the lack of basic education among slum children, they hardly realize that their future is not going to be a good one. So, it's us who have to keep a step ahead and change the shape of the things to come. And it's us who have to get our soft corners of our hearts affected, our pulps affected, and work something for this. Start a dream, start a revolution, and make it happen.
पीछे देख सकते हैं जैसे कि ये बच्चे किन गरीब हालात में जीने को मजबूर हैं। इन्हें खुद का नहीं पता कि एक कल खाना मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा। इन्हें खुद नहीं पता दर्द जो ये सह रहे हैं कल मिटेगा या नहीं मिटेगा। कल का सूरज इनके जीवन में कोई खुशियाँ लाएगा कलकत्ता में कोई ना रहे, फिर भी ये जी रहे। इनको देख के आपका दिल नहीं पसीजता, इनको देख के आपको कुछ नहीं महसूस होता, मुझे तो होता है, शायद आपको भी होता है। ये आइए हम सब मिल के कुछ ऐसा करें जिससे इनका भला, देश का भला, हम सबका भला। Let the pulp inside us show.